Bonjour guys, welcome to a brand new video today on the channel, and right now with Vincent we're gonna show you guys all 4-4-2 custom tactics and all the player instruction that you need to know and you need to set up as well in your FIFA 21 Ultimate Team. So guys, if you find this video helpful, drop a like as always and make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. As you can see guys, right now we're currently in Division 1 on FIFA 21 already. Yes, we have played some squad battle games, but most of our games now have been as well Division Rivals. You guys can see on the bottom right, on the bottom left of the screen, you guys can see our record. We're still top undefeated.
Left. It's actually top left. The screen.
So yeah, boys, half of those 31 games were on squad battle, so it doesn't really count squad battle.
Yes.
But the other half, it's actually Division Rival placement game and Division 1 and Division 2 games. So as you can see, boys, this is the team we're currently using. It's not a mega team. It's still a really good team at first with Mertens and Depay. For me, Mertens, by the way, boss, is the best striker in this game so far. We might make a player review, boss, on him, simply for the fact that I know a lot of you, bros, will want to give him a try. So now, boss, let's start with the custom tactics. And like you saw, boss, with the title, we use the 4-4-2 formation.
We believe it's one of the best formation on FIFA 21 simply because it's really balanced. You have two strikers, it's really important for the quick 1-2s up top. You have two wingers because the pace is so important this year on FIFA 21. I wish you could have a third midfielder, but two box-to-boxes slash number 6 and number 8, like as a box-to-box and center defensive mid, is good enough. I wish there were a third midfielder, but nonetheless. Right now, guys, you guys can see that we'll set up. We're going to show you guys two 4-4-2 custom tactics variables, one that's a bit more defensive and one that's a bit more offensive.
Exactly, boss, and the advice I will give you, boss, in today's video will be not to copy and paste all custom tactics, but to inspire yourself and to know. You need to know first of all, boss, what is your strength on FIFA and what is your weaknesses on FIFA. So this is why, boss, I will not advise you to copy and paste all custom tactics, because Lamina, we have a very similar playstyle, therefore we use the same custom tactics. But you don't potentially have the same playstyle as us, therefore inspire yourself but don't copy it.
Exactly. So boss, let's get right on with the custom tactics. So boss, for the defensive money, you can either use drop back, but we don't really like it personally. We think it's better on balance. So for the width of the defense, it's important when you guys defend that you guys put it either on 3 or 4, because like this, all of your wingers and all of your left back and right back will not be too spread out. Yes. It will be more or less around the same area. So this is why we leave it either on 3 or 4. Now for the depth, that's gonna be important. Defensively, we like to keep it as 4 or 5 because our playstyle is pretty offensive. We like to pressure the opponent.
Aggressive defense.
Exactly. But if it's defensive, I will advise you guys, if this is not really your playstyle, to even leave it on 3 or 4. Personally, we like to leave it on 5.
Exactly.
Now, bros, for the possession, and this is where it really matters depending on your playstyle. For Vincent and myself, it's balanced.
Exactly, boss, because we love to do some scheme off and we love to go on the whiff of the player. Therefore, boss, offensive style, balance. We don't like to take too much the possession. Whenever I have the ball, I like to move forward fairly quickly. There you go, boss. So for the whiff, we stay at 5 out of 10 simply for the fact, boss, it's super balanced. And sometimes as well, this is what I forgot to mention, boss, this is the custom tactics that we use whenever we start the game.
Yes.
That's important to mention.
So now, brothers, for player in the box, 4 out of 10. We don't really mess with it too much just for now. I think we just need to wait for the first couple of patches of FIFA 21 to start adjusting the corners, the free kick and all that, because so far we score a couple goals on corners, but it's not really working that well for us. Maybe because we don't have the likes of Varane, Virgil van Dijk, all of the best defenders just yet on the $0 FIFA points spent on Road to Glory. So guys, now for the player instruction, and this is where it's gonna matter
the most. Actually, boss, if you have to copy and paste one thing out of this video, it's actually the player instruction for the 4-4-2 formation. So it's pretty easy, boss. For the 2 full-back, which are Florenzi and Juan Bernat, stay back while attacking. This is gonna be very important because I feel like the meta in this game is very counter-attack. Therefore, you want all your 4 defenders to pretty much stay back while you're attacking.
Yes, and even if you have offensive-minded fullbacks, even if you put them stay back while attacking, sometimes they will still push forward. So make sure you guys be cautious about it. Do not trigger runs with your right back and left back, because that will leave a lot of space in behind. So you guys don't want this. Now, brothers, for the right mid, and we use comeback on defense for our right mid with getting behind. Make sure you guys use a lot of pacey winger on FIFA 21 because pace is really important. Same with Gelson Martins. Come back on defense, getting behind. And now, brothers, for the two midfielders. So,
it's important.
Here it's important because we have two box to box, more or less, really complete midfielders. They are not like insane, but they are still pretty good. Rajan Angolan and Usam Aouar. Therefore, if you guys have more or less the same similar style of players, make sure you guys use those. So for attacking support, stay back while attacking. For the defensive, this is still the defensive instruction. Cover center, this is the most important because with the 4-4-2, you don't want your right center mid to cover up the left and the right flank. You want him to stay in the middle.
Exactly, because as well, most of the opponent that you will face, even if you have all few champions, you will see that they will tend to go in the middle of the on the field. So it's going to be really important for your two CDM, or even if you have two or three center mids, if you're using another formation, that they stay in the middle.
Yes,
that's going to be very important, boss, because after you can intercept the ball fairly easily.
Now, brothers, for the two strikers, and here we have two pacey striker. I like to call it pacey because they have over 85 pace on FIFA 21. Therefore, we're going to use getting behind and stay forward for both of them.
Exactly.
However, if you guys have target man type of striker, someone like
Giroud, for example, Giroud. Even though you're not going to use Giroud, but someone tall, not very pacey, then make sure you potentially use don't get in behind, but potentially stay on balance.
Yes.
Or even target man. Yeah, for the attacking one.
Yes.
That's going to be the solution, but of course, Dries Mertens, because of his body type, is not going to be that guy that's going to win a lot of headers.
No.
He's most likely going to be the guy taking some space behind the defender. So this is why, boss, plan instruction for me, this is the key and the cake of the video.
Yes, so now, brothers, for the attacking ones. So we like to still leave it on balance. For the width, we like to keep it on 4 or 5, more or less around 5 or 6 as well, depending if we really need to score another goal with the 4-4-2 formation.
Yeah.
For the depth, this will be important. We like to keep it either as 5 or 6, more or less the width and the depth.
Defensively, doesn't really matter because as well, this is going to be the attacking 4-4-2 custom tactics. Or attacking 4-4-2 custom tactics. Therefore, boss, it's gonna be whenever we're gonna chase the game. So this is like quite of an emergency custom
situation,
tactics and formation slash custom tactics. So we like to take a lot of risk. Therefore, this is the type of custom tactics we will use, like if there's 10, 15, 20 minutes left before the end of the game. Mm. And if we see we're losing 2-0 or 1-0, those are gonna be our custom tactics. Therefore, boss, we're not gonna, we will take much risk. You know, this is important, boss, to have always two custom tactics, two formation in mind whenever you're starting the game and whenever you're chasing the game.
Yes, that's really important on FIFA 21, especially when it comes down to few champions, but that's in a couple of weeks. You guys are still sometimes to practice on FIFA 21. Now, for the offensive tactic, fast build up. It's gonna be important, boss, because we want those quick 1-2 tiki taka, especially going forward. The width, we're gonna leave it as 5. The players in the box, we're gonna put 7. For the corners, 4. Free kicks, 4.
Exactly.
Now, for the player instruction, it's gonna be more or less the same thing. We're gonna put stay back while attacking, 4 right back, 4 left back, stay back while attacking, 4-2 box to box, stay back while attacking, cover center. Yes, and then for Nangolan, stay back while attacking, cover center. This will be important because if by the time we will upgrade to Usam Aouar, Rajan Nangolan, we will keep him. But soon enough, we're going to upgrade to Usam Aouar, so we're going to take someone that's a bit more offensive and that can create a little bit more danger going forward.
Someone like KDB, for example.
Yes.
This is our target, so boys, it will all depend, stay back while attacking or balance
attack.
But right now, you might be wondering yourself, but wait, boys, if you're chasing the game because you use those custom tactics, yes, boys, because in the middle, those two center back, the four defenders actually in the two center mid, we want them to still stay back while attacking, but the difference will be on the wing.
Yes.
The two right mid, like the right mid and the left mid, this is where the danger and the chance, the changes will come, comparing to the first custom tactics that we
Yes, because here, boss, for the 4-4-2, we're gonna put our wingers on stay forward.
Yeah.
It's gonna be important for us, and then the same for Gelson Martins, stay forward. So, bros, those were our 4-4-2 custom tactics, and right now, boss, we're gonna jump on into some Division 2 slash Division 1 gameplay. With Vincent, we really wanted to show you guys some of the actions and some of the games we have played today with the 4-4-2 formation and our custom tactics, because we played an absolutely like wonderful opponent, especially you guys will see it in a couple of minutes, and those games were really entertaining for us to play, and I'm sure they will be for you guys to watch. So We're gonna be streaming as well, boss, tonight over on our Twitch channel, twitch.tv/toonsifig. Make sure you guys join in. This is where we're gonna be spending most of our time playing the games. We're gonna be playing some division rivals, maybe some few drafts. So make sure you guys come by tonight. So, boss, with the 4-4-2 formation, this is something I really wanted to say to you guys, is that we don't know yet if it's just the best formation on FIFA 21 just yet. But in my opinion, to start your game, guys, it's simply one of the best because you can adjust to your opponent and as well, you can still play your game.
Exactly, you know what I mean? And this is what I said, like, at the start of the video. You guys really need to analyze in this year what's your strength and what's your weaknesses, because at the end of the day, bros, we all have similar playstyle, right? But the meta of the game will not change, right? The meta of the game is to use spacey wingers, potentially play the tiki-taka just in front of the net, have pacey striker plays the one playing the 1-2. So I think no matter what, the meta formation this year, it can be the 4-2-3-1, it can be the 4-4-2, it can be the 4-2-4, 4-3-2, but you always need to have that two striker formation, in my opinion, and two box-to-box. At least that's going to be the way I like to see things, considering the fact as well that you have two center mid, two wingers and two strikers. For me, it's the most balanced formation, the 4-4-2 at this stage of the game. It's without any patches. If EA Sports decide to make two or three patches throughout the year, most likely that will happen, then potentially the meta of the game, definitely after the formation in this game, then they will change. But from now on, I feel like the 4-4-2 formation with all custom tactics, because this is all playstyle, are working perfectly.
And this is what we wanted to share to you guys, because I know during our Twitch streams we get a lot of those questions. And guys, this is the pay to win team. This is the game to go in Division 1. And I come up against this team and I was like, wow, okay, this guy must have spent a lot of money.
This is a real test.
Let's see what we're up to. And you guys can see that we're absolutely, I enjoy myself playing this game and absolutely battle him. Oh, Lord, look at this. Look at this.
Beautiful.
Wow.
Beautiful.
This is just impressive.
And by the way, bros, we're going to make the five. We're going to make a special video on how to show you, bros, the best five skill moves to perform in this game. The most meta skill move. Because in my opinion, bros, this year, especially if you have some five star skill move player on the wing,
it will make a huge difference.
It will make a huge difference. Potentially as well, this is why I'm really enjoying this gameplay at the moment, because I feel like the skill move with the wingers, they're super important and definitely they're making the difference just in front of the net and to create danger.
Yes, because all playstyle we like to do some skill move, and finally this year we can do some skill move, take our time with the ball and with the runs that offensive players are making. It's actually so much better and so much more enjoyable and so much more offensive compared to FIFA 20. Therefore, so far, we really like it. Yes, defensively, it's pretty hard to defend. Yes, but at least it's an offensive game and there's a lot of goals being scored every game. So, boys, you guys can see that right now. Division 1. That's it, boys. We're in Division 1. We cannot wait to open our Division Rival Rewards to upgrade the road to glory, because the team is looking like this. But tonight, we will be doing some really cool upgrade, because we earn 50,000 coins by reaching Division 1.
By the way, boss, right now we have more or less more than 150,000 coins. We've couple plus to sell yet, because we still need to sell some plus from our squad battle elite 1 squad battle rewards. Yes, so hey, boss, that's it for today's video. That was all custom tactics. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any question, let us know in the comment section down below. We have as well Twitter and Instagram if you guys want to hit us up over there. No matter what, brothers, if you enjoyed today's video and if you find it helpful, leave a like. Make sure you guys subscribe so like that you guys will be notified as soon as we upload some more videos. Thank you guys so much for the support. And bros, little disclaimer, we made as well about a week ago a French YouTube channel. So if you guys are French and if you guys want us to
understand French,
if you guys check it out, very in French, then check it out, bros. The link of it will be in the description. Thank you guys nonetheless. My name is Vincent.
My name is Vincent. Boys, stay... Bro, my name is Liam. Wait.
Wow.
My name is Liam. Apologies, boys. Make sure you guys please take care of yourself.
Wow.
Stay safe. Catch you guys tonight on Twitch. Au revoir. Wow.
Wow. Wow.